could be a while yet.
Yes!
Todd, want a ciggy? Todd, bud, ciggy. Oh, give us some back.
Smoking's bad for you, zits.
She's got me fags. Todd.
Look, mate, I don't think I'm going to have time to work on the bike today. I'm too busy.
Oh, okay. You owe me 6 lambert and butler.
Shifted.
You know what your problem is, ma'am? You're too house proud.
You don't know the meaning of the word. It's like bloody quick fit in here.
Is me good shirt clean? Me smart jeans?
Ands, not ones. Oh, get off!
Chill out, ma'am. You coming up or what?
What a dump. You should have ordered it by phone.
Stop, Jeff. She'll have your watch.
Excuse me. Are we looking for Hamlet Close?
Number?
43.
Looking for Elaine, are you? Wedding cake, is it?
Wedding vow renewal cake, actually.
Ah. Who had the affair?
Nobody.
Look at the length of them. Go on, tell us your secret.
Sorry?
How would you wipe your arse with nails like that?
Wow, that's a real talent you've got. These are works of art. Do you have some cards? We could take a few.
Wedding cards?
No, business cards with your company details.
Oh, no, I'm not a business. I just do it for pleasure, really. Well, that and the money. Oh, that's our Todd. And them are his kids, bless him.
You don't look old enough to be a grandmother.
Oh, dear flatterer.
Surely they can't both be his.
Oh, they are.
Yeah, he's been busy.
Todd's always been a good-looking lad, you see, that's the trouble. I've told him time and time again, they're only after one or two things, your body or a single mother's flat.
Oh, I'm famished.
I'm making rock cakes. Old family recipe. Is it in a church?
A hotel.
You be wearing white?
Yes.
That's nice.
Have you heard that flaming racket? I thought someone was being murdered. It's bloody not on. I need me kit.
It's me up there. Fireman. He's on nights.
I bet they've got a lovely house and family and things. It's not fair. How is it some people have everything and others?
It's nice to see that romance is alive and well, though. Renewing the wedding vows. Bet it'll be dead tasteful.
Made those little dolled up types turn into wizened old hags really quick. Those buns ready yet?
You alright, Dad?
No, actually, since you asked. For some unknown reason, I'm a bit tired.
So am I. Thanks for the biscuits.
Oh, there's one or two left. Take them home with you.
I can't.
Of course you can.
My mum won't have anything from you in the house. She says she's seen the state of your kitchen.
Take my notice, ma'am. Not all the top chefs have got scanty kitchens.
Have you had a word with him?
About what? His girlfriend's skills intact and diplomacy.
The noise. It's not funny, Elaine. I'm exhausted.
Won't I make us something nice for tea tonight? I'll set the table properly, no eating off trays, eh? Won't you come to bingo later? You haven't been for ages. Go on, you're my lucky chance, not the same without you. Any chance of another cuppa? Well, actually, Jack.
You're not got a kettle of your own at home?
Let me pass this step, somebody. My hips feel like they've been pulled out of their sockets and shoved in backwards. I'll never get over this threshold. I've overdone it. Get me to that chair. There you go.
All right.
That's better.
If you're that ill, you should have stayed at home.
Some of us who are genuinely suffering just choose to get on with our lives with as little fuss as possible. Unlike others. I don't know what's worse, spending yet another day on my own, staring at four walls, or coming round here for an afternoon with misery guts.
Yes, Mother.
It's getting old, Lark's not much fun, Elaine.
You have a lot more going for you than some people your age.
You find out one day, seeing all the old familiar faces disappearing around you. My life's like an episode from Murder, She Wrote.
What was it you're supposed to be making, Elaine?
Well, they're supposed to be rock cakes. Ooh. Ed's got to sort this out. Oh.
Holy Mary, Mother of Jesus. Look at me and tell me I'm imagining it.
I don't know what you're talking about.
What? Look at it, you silly cow. Look. It's the Virgin Mary.
Hey, she's right, you know, Elaine, it is.
Here's that cackle.
The faces look genuinely real. Just look at the detail on the eyes. And the leather pants, I'm assured, are 60% genuine leather. Oh, and I'm just being told by the lovely Hannah that we've now sold out. So let's talk to the lucky lady who's managed to buy the very last one. She's an old friend of the show, Jax Roback from Newcastle.
Yes.
Hello, Jax. Yes. Hello. You've managed to buy the last of our Bavarian dolls.
I bought it from your husband to remind him of home.
So your husband's from Germany?
No, Poland.
Get off phone. We cannot afford for you buying flipping puppets.
We could afford if you didn't send half our money home to your bloody mother every week. I'm sorry, Paul. I love you, I think you're great, but I'm going to have to go because my husband's made a showbiz on the telly.
You'll never like my mother.
What?
She treats her like a princess.
Treats me like a princess, does she, Nelly?
Help our Graham to find Miss Wright in San Francisco. Give Elaine the strength to make something of herself. She's a good enough lass on the whole, but she could do with some decent dress sense. God bless Eve and Todd. He's definitely in need of your guidance. Then there's me. All I need's a bit of company. Not that I'm ruling out sex if it's on offer. Amen.
You want to get Ed signed up for some acupuncture? Very good for stress. Robbo tried it when he was mistaken for that Pete and Tom that time. There's your mother.
She wanted to go with her friends in the minibus and she has the nerve to tell me she's lonely.
Hey!
Miss Jack's, they've gone.
Well, I come to see cake. Cake like Virgin Mary.
You what?
My man Jack says his cake just like Mary.
Mary? What, like Jesus' mum?
Is that what you mean?
Beautiful Madonna.
Can't see it myself. Mate, what are you doing?
I make a wish to the Madonna.
Make it a quick one, eh? I'm off out on the pull.
Not with Izzy?
He fancies a change.
Your thing. One day, it will drop off.
I've been on the phone to Bob Graham in America about it. He's just moved to San Francisco with his new job. Choreographer. Earning a fortune. That's my boy. Still not married yet, then. He's spoilt for choice.
Here we go. Everybody happy?
Change?
Right, yeah. £8.20. 59 £10.
You didn't want a drink, did you, Terry?
Oh, no, Millie. Not when I'm driving. I'm going to get you all home safely.
Please yourself.
So, tell me about this wonderful cake.
Not much point, really. Is Lotta not interested in the Madonna?
No, Millie. My aunt loves Madonna.
It's a lass over there. She keeps looking over. I think she likes you.
Where? Don't point, man.
There.
Cheers, Stewie boy. Where do you think you're going?
She might have a mate.
Problem is, your aftershave and my aftershave, a bad combination, mate. Mix them together and the smell of farts.
No. God, yeah.
Hi.
Hi. I haven't seen you in here before.
Aren't I supposed to say that? You want a drink?
No, I never accept drinks from strangers.
Luckily I do. You can buy me one.
You know, I'd forgotten how much I hate decorating.
I wondered.
What do you mean?
You're so bad at it. You've missed a bit there and there.
Well, look all right. From a distance.
How far? South Shields.
I don't know why people read books when you've got DVDs.
What?
I don't know why people bother to read books.
You can't say that. You get so much more from reading a novel.
Eh?
I said you get so much more from... You're winding me up, aren't you?
I know what you're thinking. Because I'm a bricky, I must be a thicky.
Sorry?
A thicky bricky! Anyway, my sister's at uni, she's always recommending books.
All right, what, you reading?
I said she recommends them. I didn't say I'll read them.
Maybe she really is lonely.
Who?
My mum. I should be more sympathetic. I can't remember the last time I heard her laugh. But properly, I mean. When my dad was alive, I suppose, and everything were different. The good old days, eh? I want my old Ed back, I miss him. Don't you stop me off.
We used to do things together all the time. We had plans. Nothing mega, just things we wanted to do when Todd and Eve had gone. New car, safari in Africa.
Africa?
I've wanted to stroke a giraffe ever since I saw them on Animal Magic. I knew it was Johnny Morris doing the voices.
Did you?
Yeah. Well, they all sounded the same. All we talk about now is what's for tea and what's on telly.
We're like two bloody strangers at a B&B. I don't want this to be my life.
I used to be like that. I could see it all in my mind, how it was going to be. Posh dinners, a lovely house. Kids. And then one day you realise it's just not going to happen.
What did you do? Tell me, because honestly, Jax, I can't go on like this.
I just stopped thinking.
All I can say, Jean, is these events happened so long ago, nobody can prove anything. Either way, you just have to have faith. You trust what's written, or you don't. Personally speaking, I don't think we are descended from aliens who crash-landed millions of years ago. But hey-ho, what do I know? It's what you believe that matters.
I hope my smile can distract you. I hope my fists can fight for two. So it never has to show.
Sausage, bacon, egg.
Rubble. When did I start letting myself go?
August 2002.
Just a grapefruit juice, please.
looking good, Stuart.
Hey, thanks, treasure. I don't care what to say about you. You might keep a filthy house, but you're a lovely woman.
What time's the funeral?
10, at the creme.
Oh, bless.
Yeah, we're cremating him. Just to make sure he doesn't come back from the dead.
Look, how quiet.
Where is it? They want to see it.
Mother, what are you playing at?
I'm a walking miracle thanks to that cake. Look.
Have you been drinking?
Through here. And no touching. And all of a sudden, the oven light started to flash brighter and brighter. So bright it was blinding.
And then she woke up.
And then, when it went out, this is what we saw.
It's not the Virgin Mary. It's just flour, eggs and E numbers.
You can't deny something miraculous happened. Look at me. I'm pain free. I can walk easily. It's like the resurrection with cake mix.
Oh, now, move out of the way. Got a funeral cake, eh, man? Have some respect.
Have you seen Todd?
No.
I've been leaving him messages and he's not called us back. Well, you were out with him last night, weren't you?
Aye, I was. Look, Izzy, there comes a point in your life when you realise you've just got to cut your losses and move on.
He got off with someone, didn't he?
Miracles, I ask you.
Well, I had them in the olden days.
Yes, but they don't happen now. And not here.
Anyway, I only came round for a coffee.
I've no food left. They've eaten me out of house and home.
Got any carrot sticks?
Carrot sticks?
It's that cake, isn't it?
Yes! Waddell!
Easy, Todd. You look dead rough.
I'm looking for someone.
I've found someone. This is Carly. She works for the Undertakers. But it's cool, she doesn't touch the stiffs. That bird you went off with last night was well fit.
Yeah. We spent the whole night just talking.
What were you talking about all night?
Life. I know where she lives, though. She pointed it out.
So what's the problem?
I can't find her. It's an apartment block.
Come on.
Later, babes.
So, you didn't get her apartment number, and you don't know her surname. Right. Sally in? We're looking for a Sally.
She's got long blonde hair, big brown eyes, and an amazing smile.
Sally?
What's Sally?
You know her?
Well, not exactly, but if you want to come up and call me Sally for a few hours, I really don't mind, like.
It's on! I'm on!
I used to be a dancer, Christine.
Come on, you're supposed to be taping this for our Graham.
Arthritis. Now, I'd like to talk to you about that, because you've admitted...
She's a good-looking lass, that Christine. Very intelligent as well. I wish you could have made something of yourself, Elaine. What a waste.
It all started when you touched the cake that night. The Virgin Mary cake. You touched the cake, and then what?
Hello? How are you? Ed, no, he's at work.
Jeff!
Hello, Mrs. Dunstan.
What are you doing?
I'm coming in.
Don't be ridiculous. Take a photo for the album. Hang
mum.
Unreliable, you see. I have to...
It's a wedding cake woman. She's on the news.
What's she done?
Miracle cake, but I don't think so.
Brilliant. A miracle cake. Quick! She's on the television. Millie, on the telly.
Look,
it's a true miracle, Jacqueline. From now on, nothing will be same.
What's this crap? What do you play at?
I'm on a diet and I'm enjoying it. Chew everything 36 times. It aids digestion and makes you feel less hungry.
You want to lose weight? Great. Me, I don't need.
You do need. It's called supporting your wife.
What about supporting husband? I'm starving.
It's me, Mary.
I was watching that. Oh, you didn't put money on Lecky car, did you?
Ed's boss was on the phone. They're worried about him. Not me turning up for work. Not regularly, anyway. Brings in sick sometimes, I'd no idea. What's he playing at?
I knew it.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing, nothing.
You think he's having an affair? Why are all your lights out?
Just... out.
Come on, Deckard.
Thanks, I'll pay you back, I promise.
I know.
We had an accident. He sat on his radio. Little fix. He's asleep now.
I'm not surprised. You've exhausted him.
Hey, this looks nice.
Be empty, please.
Cheers.
Cheers. There's a bit of paint on there. He's used to playing the hero, you see, so I left him alone. I thought it was what he wanted. But you stop talking about one thing in your life, and before you know it, you've stopped talking about everything. Do you think he's having an affair? No, I'm not sure either, Kenny.
Hello?
Needn't have bothered to bring him back.
Oh, we thought you might like to recycle. Oh, saved a piece for you.
Oh, really? Thanks. How'd it go, your wedding thing?
Thing? Ah, that's good, yeah, that sums it up. But the cake was delicious. Oh, yeah, saw you on the TV. The miracle cake, what a story.
Load of rubbish, really. Driving us nuts, she'll get rid of the damn thing. How's your wife?
She's good, yeah. She enjoyed the day.
What can I do for you?
I was wondering if you'd ever thought about setting up your own catering firm. Weddings, parties, that sort of thing. That's what I do, you see. I invest in your businesses.
Hiya.
Hi. I don't need an answer straight away. You can, we can talk in a few days.
She's married.
Do you mind? We're discussing business. Yes, fancy that. Why aren't you at work?
Older sickie.
Like father, like son.
He's in love. Oh, shut up. Mum, if you were a lass, like a young lass. And there was a lad after you.
Those were the days.
And see, he was interested, but you weren't that bothered.
Don't tell me Todd the stud's been turned down.
No. Well, it's difficult to explain. What can I do?
Send some flowers. Or some fags, if you knew her full address.
Your dad used to send me little notes. He used to leave them all over the place for me to find. Flowers are fine. Oh. Words. Words are special.
Here. You've taped the wrong channel. What's your brother going to say? It's 20 minutes of some posh lass trying to sell a house. Our Graham will be furious. I might have known. I can't trust you to do anything.
I suppose your stupid miracle cake baked itself, did it? But that's okay, don't thank me. Why break the habit of a lifetime, eh, ma'am? Sorry, chosen one. I'm pleased I taped the wrong show. At least our Graham can't see that his mother's turned into an ego mad pain in the arse.
Get you?
Nice one, Mrs. Wilson.
Never mind that.
Mint, are we gonna break in?
Careful.
He said there was only gonna be a few words. This is a busted book.
There you go.
That's nothing. I promised I'd fix it. For one of the lads at work.
Didn't know they employed toddlers in the fire service.
What's with all the questions?
I had a phone call yesterday. Your station officer's worried about you. Taking time off, calling in sick. How come all this is news to me?
I've been seeing my counsellor, haven't I? I mean, the boss should know.
Yeah, but taking time off, calling in sick, what's going on?
Nothing. Where do you think I was?
At the station. But where you were before, that's anybody's guess.
Have you been checking up on me? For a few days.
I'm not stupid. I know something's going on.
That's all you think.
So tell me.
Claire Snowden's been having a rough time since Steve died.
Steve's Claire? Well, why didn't you say I could have come with you, kept her company?
You hardly know her.
Didn't know you did.
It's tough for her. I've been helping out.
Surely she's got her own family. Why keep it a secret? Why didn't you talk to me?
You're joking, aren't you? We never get the chance to talk. We never even get the chance to be alone. It's an open house here all the bloody time.
You're making excuses now. How often are you going round there?
Oh, have you ever done exercise? The fat just drops off you.
See what I mean?
Look, Elaine, we can't even have a private conversation in our own home without someone barging in and sticking their oar in. Your friends, your mother.
Steve's death wasn't your fault. It were an accident. A horrible accident. The job you do, sometimes that happens. Steve knew that. You shouldn't feel guilty about still being alive, Ed. You don't owe Claire anything.
I'm keeping down the station for a while. I'll see you.
Well, it's just you and me, kid.
What's up, man?
Nothing. Your dad's spending a few days at the station. I think we might be.
Yes, result. She got the message.
I have to say, Elaine, it wasn't one of your best either. A bit dry.
I think he's left me, Jax.
That's it. Good as new.
Jack, we so chuffed. Oh.
I'll have another look at it.
Not to worry.
I better be off.
Ed. I don't know what I would have done without you this past few months.
I know. Me decorating toy fixing skills are the envy of Tideside.
Funny the way things turn out.
Yeah.
If you need somewhere to stay, you can. It's here. It's no trouble. Steve would have wanted you to. I want you to. Hello, Mrs. Dunstan. It's Elaine Wilson. The cake lady.
Yes.
You've got a lovely house. It's beautiful. Looks like your front drive's been hoovered.
Yes.
Could I speak to Jeff, please?
I'm afraid he's out.
He wanted to know if I fancied starting a new venture. Cakes and things. Asked me to think about it. Well, I've thought about it.
You must have caught the wrong end of the stick.
No, it was only this morning.
I'm sorry. Jeff doesn't invest in small businesses anymore. He's retired.
I do get the wrong end of the stick sometimes. Never listen properly, my mother says, but I'm sure he said. It seemed like a good idea, you see. Give me his card.
Let me see. Well, he never... Well, he's got other priorities now.
Never mind. I'm sorry to have troubled you.
Should have rung first. You'd have saved yourself a long bus ride. Goodbye.
Denise from Heaton said she never lost her hope in spite of everything. Tommy's sudden disappearance. The twins emigrating without telling her. But last week, she won 60 quid on the lottery and she's happy as Larry. You have to be optimistic. And now, the late, great Perry Como.
Hello? Oh. If you're ringing up to apologise, Elaine, don't.
Jack says what? It's impossible. The greedy fat bitch! Stuart! Oh, you gave me a fright.
Miss Wilson, I need to touch the magic cake again. My spots went. I felt different. But the worst now, that's why she chucked us. I've got to touch it.
Sweetheart, it's gone. Eaten.
What am I going to do?
If she ditched it over a few spots, she's a stupid, shallow lass and she don't deserve you. You'll meet someone who's attracted to you because of who you are. Oh, love and life, pet, it's about chemistry. Not cookery.
Hey, you! You didn't pick me up.
Well, sorry, Millie, I didn't think you were coming at afternoon bingo anymore.
I had to walk all the way and my feet are killing me.
If you're as fit as you say you are, why didn't you jog round?
I always knew you were a jealous woman, Peggy Hall.
Jealous of you? The bearded lady?
I knew you couldn't keep away.
Your message was sweet.
I had to find you again. It wasn't easy. I had a good time.
So did I.
You fancy a drink? Or a coffee?
Todd, I can't see you again.
Why not?
I can't.
I don't understand.
I don't want a big relationship.
So let's just see where it goes. It's not like we're talking wedding bells, is it? Or kids. I've got two of those already. I don't want any more. It's okay, they wouldn't get in the way, I hardly see them.
And why not?
One of the mums moved to Leeds and the others...
I have to go.
Don't!
You've sort of made it easier for me. Don't leave any more messages. Bye, Todd. Nobody's talking to me. They say I'm big-headed.
Now, 26.
I know, ridiculous. Green-eyed witches.
Well, there probably is a bit of jealousy going around. Just sit there with your mouth shut for a while.
Oh, Chat Magazine rang. They want to do an interview. No, just me. They didn't mention you. Will you come and pick me up, Elaine? I don't want to stay here. I'm not very well.
Mother, there's nothing wrong with you. I have to go.
Hi.
Oh. You get around a lot for a retired man.
I thought it was special.
Well, maybe she changed her mind. I mean, they do that sometimes.
I shouldn't have mentioned the kids. I told her they didn't matter.
Women love the thoughtful gestures. Flowers, notes made of pebbles. But what they really need to know is that they can rely on you.
Well, she could.
Could she? I mean, Todd, now you give a good impression of someone who's sailing through life, shirking his responsibilities. I mean, a lass might think that's what you'd be like in a relationship. She'd end up doing all the graft. And keeping things together.
I wouldn't do that to her.
Easy to say, son. Sometimes you don't even know you're doing it.
Everybody up now. Ready?
Okay, put your hands up in the air.
Come on, like it.
So much for being the chosen one.
Judith wants me to have my teeth bleached.
Take long holidays.
I spend the rest of my days lying with cucumber in my eyes at some punsy health farm.
Fancy swapping places, because you've just described my fantasy life.
It's not mine. I like being involved.
Why me? Of all the things you could put your money into, why this? Why me?
Because you have a great commodity. Yourself. And there's a market out there that wants your products. It's that simple.
Is it?
You want to do something with your talents? It would be an awful shame if you never got to fulfill any of your dreams. Start believing in yourself, Elaine. Because I do.
I don't usually. Stupid bitch. You said some nice things, and it's been a while since. Oh, I'm sorry, I really am. Everything's a bit of a mess.
A mess can be tidied up, I find. Maybe I can help. Better be off.
What are you doing here?
Well, this is still my home. I thought Todd might be around.
He's out. How's Claire?
I told you. I'm down at the station.
Ed? Claire wasn't the only one who lost her husband in that fire.
Oh, Lynn, it's your mum.
Oh, Mum. I don't want to see you. That'll be why you rang my best friend. Miracle cake. I've got a dodgy ticker. And every bone in my body aches 10 times more than it did before I saw the damn thing. Should have known it was all too good to be true. Everything you've touched turns pear-shaped. Did you phone our Graham? Is he coming? He wanted to, but rehearsals for Hello Dolly are at a tricky stage. He sends his love. I've had a word with the doctor. When you're well enough to leave, you're coming home with me.
I think Ed might have something to say about that.
Ed won't be there.
So he's finally left you? Oh, Elaine, I think me and you must be cursed. Cursed and damned to hell.
That's right, Mother, you stay positive. I thought you might want your wall paint. On you later. Drop.
Elaine. Thank you.
Oh. Robert, are you happy? I mean, content with what you've got.
I'm whole. Oi. I think you watch too much television, too much opera.
Opera?
Oprah Winfrey.
Ah, Oprah. Is that all? I promised to stop buying the flipping puppets. It's stupid, really. Grown woman.
Ah, you keep what you like. Except that kinky, devil, doll monster. It follows me with the eyes. You send back.
Deal.
You eat. I like.
That's what rock cakes are supposed to look like. Given any more thought to what we talked about?
It's really kind of you to offer.
Kindness doesn't come into it. Jake loves you being around. I want you here with me.
There's only one person you want to see walking through that door. And it's not me. What the hell happened?
Well, put it this way, you won't have to repair the cooker. I'm fine. Todd's still not home, if that's why you've come round.
It wasn't Todd I came to see. I thought you might have company.
Who? Oh, Jeff. Your turn to check up on me.
No.
It won't what you think. It's just pie in the sky. I mean, look at the state of this place. How could I run a professional business? I can barely keep my own kitchen from burning to the ground.
What business?
I know, ridiculous. Show me all life I've done now. Well, not for myself anyway. And then Jeff from Darris Hall turns up offering me my own shop just because him and his snotty wife liked me cakes. He just said some nice things. I was flattered, and that's all there is to it.
You are talented. I hope you told him you'd think about it.
Well, how could I with everything that's going on? My head's all over the place. I can't do it anymore, Ed. I can't. Oh, look at the place. It's ruined.
It just looks like it is.
I bless the day I found you. I want to stay around you. Now and forever.
You alright?
Yeah, I'm alright.
Your mum's gonna be okay, isn't she?
Right, so.
Elaine.
It's okay. I know. Each night we love. I found complete love. Without you.
Don't
Millie, I'd like to introduce you to Anthony. I believe you're going to be nervous.
Go around the back for a fag.
Nah, I'm not that bothered.
You sure?
Oh, right, yeah.
How'd you do? Welcome.
This is our daughter, Sally.
This is Carl, my son.
And her fiancé, Alan.
Come on, mate, let's get you a drink.
Well done you, eh?
Thank you.
Do you mind if I borrow her for a moment? It's the people I'd like you to meet.
A sunshine cake, it does more good than a big thick steak.
Start with a tablespoon of trouble, then add a smile and let it bubble up.
We ought to bake a sunshine cake.
It isn't really so hard to make.
Fresh tears, a pound or two of pleasure.